Well, so you can go welcome on to Coventry International. It's been nice to turn a 4-year match in here tonight. As we have the first of our month meetings, our May 4-year-old meeting, and as you can see, a little bit back goes. So a double hit of motorsport for us this evening here at Coventry. Our own F1 boys are in town, all big stars are here, including the world champion Tom Harris. Junior Wayman with a fresh engine put into his, this is some absolutely spectacular action. That's nice setting up, thank goodness for that. We've waited a long time to get the sun here. We've got a top table full of trophies for the guys to aim at winning. Now, the Unlimited Bangers is the Coventry Masters, and we've been searching that event for about the last 5 or 6 years. It's always been very successful, and when we bring the Unlimiteds out on town, there are really no holding bangers. So a good variety of cars coming out onto the circuit is to see the Volvos are in place. Then we get the Jags, not many of those left, but oh, there's and a Galaxy. Or is it a Toyota? Probably a Toyota. So a good mixture of cars here for the Unlimited. And a different pleasure. Ready to put the bangers to start us off. We've got 2 qualifying heats from the bangers before we turn our attentions to the Frisco Formula 1s. It's the Coventry Championship this evening, and as I say, all the big stars are here. Check your programs out, let's have all listed in there. We thank Tank Tools and Blue Base who are sponsoring the Unlimited.
So a 12 lap race, the first race of the night here at Brandon, Coventry Stadium. And full contact formula, these guys race up and down the country. And no doubt we'll see some fire from these guys this evening, lots of action. Here they go, first turn already, a bit of contact, and one or two of the cars already spinning around here. Redden there in the 148 car, he's already facing the oncoming traffic, 331. Takes a warning action, that's Boxer Jack on the inside, he moves. Already one or two cars on the infield section, but early race leader 268, Bradley French from 231 in second place. So Stu Dunn comes through into second, goodness me, 902 into that far corner near the pit turn. And this is, the guys are really mixing it early on. Normally we save this to one of the latter races, but at the moment, lots of scores being settled out there. 902 was well and truly forced into the wires. Lewis Brough in the old yellow car there. 247, Lee Clark making good progress now. That's the orange car with the black roof. But the leaders coming to view one more time. 231 leading from 275 and 318. So that's the order. Will speak in the 318 car. The pink car now starting to challenge for second position. But the early race leader, 231, Stu Dunn. Arrived late at the stadium, but he's got himself well motivated for this one. So there's the leader, 231 in second place, 318, and then 196 now begin to motor through the field. An extra to tonight's programme, 196 in the all-black car, currently in third place. Boxer Jack in 331. Dunn leading. And got himself quite a distance ahead of the 318 car of Speak. 331 moving quite rapidly through the turns. Just lines himself up down the back straight in third position and challenging hard now to see if he can get himself ahead of the 318 car. So it's Stu Dunn in that lead position. Second Speak. And third is Boxer Jack. second place this one. The first three cars, they're separated, a couple of car lengths separating first, second and third. Pat Mark was ahead of the leaders, but it's still 2-3-1. That distance between himself and second place speed now closer dramatically. It's getting more competitive further down the field. 2:68. Probably French being chased down by 1:29 down the back straight. And it's three to go next time for first, second and third, so this one's going to go all the way to the chequered flag by the looks of things. Still done, leading, speaking second. Boxer Jack in third place, just trying to get himself on the back end of the pink car, 3-1-8. Leader goes wide, so Speak moves through, by the looks of things, just about to take the lead. Will Speak, your new leader in 3-1-8, 2-3-1, trying to hang on. Up against the Arco down the back straight, almost side by side. Here comes the challenge from 3:31, bit of contact down the back of Speak. Moving to second position, got himself a good inside racing line. Speak cuts across him. Dunn's not giving up an inch either, and it's very close for those three cars, and just a place further back looks to be the 4-4-8 car. First, second and third into the pit turn one more time. Little nudge there from third place, 2:31. Boxer Jack trying to hang on to that second place. He might just go. Oh, he's going to come unstuck. Second's gone. Speak now with a pretty much clear track ahead of him. And he's got himself with a chequered flag ready. Chequered flag goes down 3:18. Second 2:31 from 3:48 in third position over the line. Two next across the line from 2:47. So Luke Clark, they're closer to finish, we think, in fifth position. Just have those checked through on the lap charts. That will do us, please, Mr. Starter. Red flags and red lights. End of the first race of the night. Confirmation. 3-1-8, your race winner.
Let's speak, ladies and gentlemen. 3-1-8. We love the Speaks here at Coventry. We'll be meeting Rob a little bit later on with the F1s. Not taking prisoners again, are you, Wilf? No. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up there. Wilf Speak on his way round. Give him a round of applause. We love the winners at the Primary Stadium. And I don't feel much better than the Speak family in this level. They really don't. Great stuff. Good to see you, Wilf, there. Turned into a good part. I know it's not listening to your programme. That's an oversight, I'm afraid. So, heat two will be...